brothers and sisters in Christ? Are any of you feeling vulnerable, afraid, or in desperate need of divine protection? Fear not, for I come to you today with a message of hope and security found in the unshakable Word of God. In this fallen world plagued by spiritual attacks and deception, it is crucial that we equip ourselves with the full armor of God. As the Apostle Paul exhorts in Ephesians 6:11, "Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil." But how do we adorn ourselves with this heavenly armor? By meditating day and night on the living and active Word of our Lord. Today I have prepared for you a powerful collection of 100 Bible verses that will serve as an impenetrable fortress, shielding you from every assault of the enemy. By committing these verses to memory and allowing them to penetrate the depths of your heart, you will experience the reality of Isaiah 54:17, which declares, "No weapon formed against you shall prosper." So let us now embark on this transformative journey through the life-altering scriptures that will fortify our faith and surround us with the impenetrable love of our Heavenly Father.
Number 1.
Psalm 91:1. "He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty."
Number 2.
Psalm 91:4. "He shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler."
Number 3.
Psalm 91:11. "For he shall give his angels charge over you, to keep you in all your ways."
Number 4.
Psalm 121:7-8. "The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in, from this time forth, and even forevermore."
Number 5.
Psalm 34:7. "The angel of the Lord encamps all around those who fear him and delivers them."
Number 6.
Psalm 46:1. "God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble."
Number 7.
Psalm 32:7. "You are my hiding place. You shall preserve me from trouble. You shall surround me with songs of deliverance."
Number 8.
Psalm 138:7. "Though I walk in the midst of trouble, you will revive me. You will stretch out your hand against the wrath of my enemies, and your right hand will save me."
Number 9.
Proverbs 18:10. "The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run to it and are safe."
Number 10.
2 Thessalonians 3:3. "But the Lord is faithful, who will establish you and guard you from the evil one."
Number 11.
Isaiah 43:2. "When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you."
Number 12.
Deuteronomy 31:6. "Be strong and of good courage. Do not fear nor be afraid of them. For the Lord your God, he is the one who goes with you. He will not leave you nor forsake you."
Number 13.
Psalm 23:4. "Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me."
Number 14.
1.7. "The Lord is good, a stronghold in the day of trouble, and he knows those who trust in him."
Number 15.
Psalm 4:8. "I will both lie down in peace and sleep. For you alone, O Lord, make me dwell in safety."
Number 16.
Psalm 27:1. "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?"
Number 17.
Psalm 140:4. "Keep me, O Lord, from the hands of the wicked. Preserve me from violent men who have purposed to make my steps stumble."
Number 18.
Psalm 121:5-6. "The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night."
Number 19.
Psalm 57:1. "Be merciful to me, O God. Be merciful to me. For my soul trusts in you, and in the shadow of your wings I will make my refuge until these calamities have passed by."
Number 20.
Psalm 61:3. for you have been a shelter for me, a strong tower from the enemy.
Number 21.
Psalm 91, 9-10. Because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling.
Number 22.
Psalm 91, 14-16. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Number 23.
Psalm 18:2. The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer. My God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold.
Number 24.
Psalm 3:3. But you, O Lord, are a shield for me, my glory, and the one who lifts up my head.
Number 25.
Psalm 5:11. But let all those rejoice who put their trust in you. Let them ever shout for joy, because you defend them. Let those also who love your name be joyful in you.
Number 26.
Psalm 9:9. The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble.
Number 27.
Psalm 12:7. You shall keep them, O Lord. You shall preserve them from this generation forever.
Number 28.
Psalm 16:1. Preserve me, O God, for in you I put my trust.
Number 29.
Psalm 17:8. Keep me as the apple of your eye. Hide me under the shadow of your wings.
Number 30.
Psalm 21. May the Lord answer you in the day of trouble. May the name of the God of Jacob defend you.
Number 31.
Psalm 25:20. Keep my soul and deliver me. Let me not be ashamed, for I put my trust in you.
Number 32.
Psalm 27:5. For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret place of his tabernacle he shall hide me. He shall set me high upon a rock.
Number 33.
Psalm 31:20. You shall hide them in the secret place of your presence from the plots of man. You shall keep them secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongues.
Number 34.
Psalm 32:10. Many sorrows shall be to the wicked, but he who trusts in the Lord, mercy shall surround him.
Number 35.
Psalm 34:19. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all.
Number 36.
Psalm 37:28. For the Lord loves justice and does not forsake his saints. They are preserved forever, but the descendants of the wicked shall be cut off.
Number 37.
Psalm 37:39. But the salvation of the righteous is from the Lord. He is their strength in the time of trouble.
Number 38.
Psalm 41:2. The Lord will preserve him and keep him alive, and he will be blessed on the earth. You will not deliver him to the will of his enemies.
Number 39.
Psalm 46:7. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
Number 40.
Psalm 50:15. Call upon me in the day of trouble. I will deliver you, and you shall glorify me.
Number 41.
Psalm 54:4. Behold, God is my helper. The Lord is with those who uphold my life.
Number 42.
Psalm 55:22. Cast your burden on the Lord, and he shall sustain you. He shall never permit the righteous to be moved.
Number 43.
Psalm 59:16. But I will sing of your power. Yes, I will sing aloud of your mercy in the morning, for you have been my defense and refuge in the day of my trouble.
Number 44.
Psalm 62:2. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be greatly moved.
Number 45.
Psalm 63:7. Because you have been my help, therefore in the shadow of your wings I will rejoice.
Number 46.
Psalm 71:3. Be my strong refuge, to which I may resort continually. You have given the commandment to save me. for you are my rock and my fortress.
Number 47.
Psalm 73:26. My flesh and my heart fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever.
Number 48.
Psalm 94:22. But the Lord has been my defense, and my God, the rock of my refuge.
Number 49.
Psalm 97:10. You who love the Lord hate evil. He preserves the souls of his saints. He delivers them out of the hand of the wicked.
Number 50.
Psalm 118:6. The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do to me?
Number 51.
Psalm 119:114. You are my hiding place and my shield. I hope in your word.
Number 52.
Psalm 121:3. He will not allow your foot to be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber.
Number 53.
Psalm 125:2. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people from this time forth and forever.
Number 54.
Psalm 145:20. The Lord preserves all who love him, but all the wicked he will destroy.
Number 55.
Psalm 146:9. The Lord watches over the strangers. He relieves the fatherless and widow. But the way of the wicked he turns upside down.
Number 56.
Proverbs 2:8. He guards the paths of justice and preserves the way of his saints.
Number 57.
Proverbs 3:26. For the Lord will be your confidence and will keep your foot from being caught.
Number 58.
Proverbs 14:26. In the fear of the Lord there is strong confidence, and his children will have a place of refuge.
Number 59.
Proverbs 18:10. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run to it and are safe.
Number 60.
Proverbs 29:25. The fear of man brings a snare, but whoever trusts in the Lord shall be safe.
Number 61.
Proverbs 35. Every word of God is pure. He is a shield to those who put their trust in him.
Number 62.
Isaiah 26:3. You will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you.
Number 63.
Isaiah 41:10. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand.
Number 64.
Isaiah 43:1. But now, thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. You are mine.
Number 65.
Isaiah 54:17. No weapon formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue which rises against you in judgment you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is from me, says the Lord.
Number 66.
Jeremiah 1:19. They will fight against you, but they shall not prevail against you. For I am with you, says the Lord, to deliver you.
Number 67.
Jeremiah 15:20. And I will make you to this people a fortified bronze wall, and they will fight against you, but they shall not prevail against you. For I am with you to save you and deliver you, says the Lord.
Number 68.
Jeremiah 39:18. For I will surely deliver you, and you shall not fall by the sword, but your life shall be as a prize to you, because you have put your trust in me, says the Lord.
Number 69.
Ezekiel 34:12. As a shepherd seeks out his flock on the day he is among his scattered sheep, so will I seek out my sheep and deliver them from all the places where they were scattered on a cloudy and dark day.
Number 70.
Daniel 3:17. If that is the case, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us from your hand, O King.
Number 71.
Daniel 6:22. My God sent his angel and shut the lions' mouths, so that they have not hurt me, because I was found innocent before him. And also, O King, I have done no wrong before you.
Number 72.
Zechariah 2:5. For I, says the Lord, will be a wall of fire all around her, and I will be the glory in her midst.
Number 73.
Zechariah 9:15. The Lord of hosts will defend them. They shall devour and subdue with slingstones. They shall drink and roar as if with wine. They shall be filled with blood like basins, like the corners of the altar.
Number 74.
Malachi 3:6. For I am the Lord, I do not change. Therefore you are not consumed, O sons of Jacob.
Number 75.
Matthew 10:29-31. Are not two sparrows sold for a copper coin? And not one of them falls to the ground apart from your Father's will. But the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Do not fear, therefore. You are of more value than many sparrows.
Number 76.
Luke 12:32. Do not fear, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom.
Number 77.
John 10:28-29. And I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall anyone snatch them out of my hand. My Father, who has given them to me, is greater than all, and no one is able to snatch them out of my Father's hand.
Number 78.
Romans 8:31. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us?
Number 79.
Romans 8:35. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword?
Number 80.
Romans 8:38-39. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing, shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Number 81.
2 Corinthians 4:8-9. We are hard pressed on every side, yet not crushed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Struck down, but not destroyed.
Number 82.
Ephesians 6:11. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
Number 83.
Ephesians 6:13. Therefore take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand.
Number 84.
Philippians 4:7. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus.
Number 85.
2 Thessalonians 3:3. But the Lord is faithful, who will establish you and guard you from the evil one.
Number 86.
2 Timothy 4:18. And the Lord will deliver me from every evil work and preserve me for his heavenly kingdom. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen.
Number 87.
Hebrews 13:6. So we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, I will not fear. What can man do to me?
Number 88.
1 Peter 3:12. For the eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and his ears are open to their prayers. But the face of the Lord is against those who do evil.
Number 89.
1 Peter 5:7. Casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you.
Number 90.
2 Peter 2:9. Then the Lord knows how to deliver the godly out of temptations, and to reserve the unjust under punishment for the day of judgment.
Number 91.
1 John 4:4. You are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because he who is in you is greater than he who is in the world.
Number 92.
1 John 5:18. We know that whoever is born of God does not sin, but he who has been born of God keeps himself, and the wicked one does not touch him.
Number 93.
Jude 1:24. Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy.
Number 94.
Revelation 3:10. Because you have kept my command to persevere, I also will keep you from the hour of trial which shall come upon the whole world to test those who dwell on the earth.
Number 95.
Deuteronomy 33:27. The eternal God is your refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. He will thrust out the enemy from before you and will say, destroy.
Number 96.
Joshua 1:9. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and of good courage. Do not be afraid, nor be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go.
Number 97.
1 Samuel 2:9. He will guard the feet of his saints, but the wicked shall be silent in darkness. For by strength no man shall prevail.
Number 98.
2 Samuel 22, 3-4. The God of my strength, in whom I will trust, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold and my refuge, my Savior, you save me from violence. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies.
Number 99.
2 Kings 6:16-17. So he answered, do not fear, for those who are with us are more than those who are with them. And Elisha prayed and said, Lord, I pray, open his eyes that he may see. Then the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw. And behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire all around Elisha.
Number 100.
2 Chronicles 16-9. For the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth, to show himself strong on behalf of those whose heart is loyal to him. In this you have done foolishly. Therefore, from now on you shall have wars. After meditating on and internalizing these 100 powerful verses, you will be transformed from the inside out. The promises of God's protection will become more than just words on a page. They will be etched upon your heart, fortifying your faith, and filling you with unwavering confidence in the Lord's unfailing love and care. Jesus himself declared in John 14:27, peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. By daily immersing yourself in these life-giving scriptures, you will experience a profound peace that surpasses all understanding, a peace that guards your heart and mind in Christ Jesus. The psalmist boldly proclaims in Psalm 112, 7-8, he will not be afraid of evil tidings. His heart is steadfast, trusting in the Lord. His heart is established. He will not be afraid. This is the unwavering promise for those who make the Word of God their dwelling place. Fear, anxiety, and dread will have no foothold in your life, for you will be firmly rooted in the unshakable truth of God's protection. So, my dear brothers and sisters, I urge you to make the commitment to meditate on these verses day and night. As you do, you will bear witness to the fulfillment of Psalm 1:3, which says, he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. Your life will be a testament to the power of God's word, and you will experience his blessings in abundance. Now, I invite you to share your favorite verse from this collection in the comment box below. Let us encourage one another and spur each other on to hide God's word in our hearts. And don't forget to like this video, share it with your loved ones, and subscribe to this channel for more life-transforming content. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.